since the surgery, I got a referral to a pain clinic, and that was life-changing. Like, learning how to not panic with the pain, because the more you get upset about the pain, the more aware of it you are and the more it hurts, right? I just think those things kind of like build on each other, and the stress of it just enhances it. And so I did some mindfulness training with two different therapists, actually, which really helped. But I also was able to, at the pain clinic in Ottawa, there was a study, a research study happening when I got referred. Basically, they were looking at taking people who are using the emergency room for pain control issues and taking them away from there and giving them a place to go and a place to call. So I was really lucky, and I got the cool side of the study. It was a double blind, right? So some people just got access to the clinic, but some of us got this new program where we had an anesthesiologist assigned to us, like a pain doctor. We also got a nurse assigned to us, a psychologist, a social worker, and there were options to also see an occupational therapist, a dietitian, anything you might need that might improve your quality of life, make you calmer, and thus lessen your pain, right? So they were the ones who hooked me up with this. So I stopped having to go to the emergency room because I was passing out all the time, which was really nice. Like, you know, I mostly prevent that now. I don't get to the point where I feel like I'm going to fall over anymore. And for me, I mean, I know it's not like this specific pain, but just the reassurance of all of that. When I do have really bad pain nights, I'm a little bit more able to relax into it and go through the steps of, okay, what do I try now? Do we try some heat? Do we try painkillers? Am I going to smoke some pot? Pot's been amazing, I have to say. I got my prescription before my big treatment, even after my second surgery for diagnosis. I got my pot prescription, and I take the allotted like 10% of the amount that I used to take, you know, like 90% of it's gone. And I take less Ativan for the stress, because man, sleeping is tough when your brain's rolling. And it also knocked out the anti-nauseants. So it's been this like learning what works, piling them on top of each other until it works. I find heat pads really great. Who knew? Somebody brought me a heat pad after one of my surgeries into the hospital that I could plug into the wall. What a difference. But the doctors aren't the people that tell you this. It's other patients, you know? And just learning to live with the pain, and, you know, sometimes I'm going to be cranky because I'm in a lot of pain, and I can see that now, instead of my partner like just being on edge all day and I thinking it's him. Oh wait, this is me. I've been a jerk today because I'm cranky because I'm in pain. And it's just been a weird learning curve, you know. And there are still days where I'm sick of it and tired and I cry and I get upset, and then there are days where I'm like, screw you, pain, I'm going to go about it anyways. And I think it takes a lot of like mental capacity to be able to overcome some of that. And some days you have it and some days you don't.